Ladies and gentlemen, Chase finally did it. Both the Chase Sapphire Preferred and the Chase Sapphire Reserve got much needed revamp on August 16th. Even more good news is that both the card received significant upgrades without having their annual fee increased. Now, in this video, what I want to do is find out an answer to one simple question. With all these new perks and benefits, has Chase Sapphire Preferred finally became a keeper card? So let's do a deep dive on this card and find out. Don't worry, I will do a separate video on Chase Sapphire Reserve and all its updated benefits, so please subscribe to the channel if you want to see that. But without further ado, let's get started with the video. So before Chase announced new perks and benefits for Chase Sapphire Preferred, this card was basically good for one thing, the signup bonus. Other than that, this card was useless. So it was good for first year because you got the signup bonus, but other than that, it had nothing else going for it. But with all these new perks and benefits added to this card, let's see if this card finally became a keeper card. So first, let's look at all the new perks and benefits added to this card. So this was the news article released by Chase on August 10th. So this article basically goes over all the new perks and benefits added to both the Chase Sapphire Preferred and the Reserve cards. So let's look at it. So first benefit added to this card starting August 16th is 5x total points on all travel purchased through the Ultimate Reward, which is a much needed benefit because both the Freedom cards have this and it looks like this was late to the party. So second benefit is 3x points on dining, including eligible delivery services, takeouts, and dining out. So yeah, this was also much needed because both the Freedom cards have this as well. So previously it was just 2x on all dining. So another new benefit added is 3x points on select streaming service, which is a good thing, I guess, but you're not gonna be spending that much on streaming services to rack up any significant points on that. So next new benefit we have is 3x points on online grocery purchases, not physical purchases, but just online. And it excludes Target, Walmart, and other wholesale clubs like Sam's Club and Costco. I guess it's something, but if it was just grocery, it might be more useful, but it's still better than nothing. Now, the next benefit is pretty juicy. $50 annual credit on hotel stays purchased through Ultimate Reward. That benefit is something everyone could benefit from, in my opinion, of course. Now, next one we have is 10% anniversary points bonus. So each account anniversary card member will earn bonus points equal to 10% of total purchases made the previous year. This means 25,000 in spend will earn a total of 2,500 bonus points. Again, it's something, but I don't think that's the reason enough to keep the card long term. Moving on, we have new Sapphire Preferred card holder can currently, yeah, that's just the signup bonus. Other one is the slick new card design. To be honest, the new design is pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. Moving on, Sapphire Preferred card members will continue enjoying all the card already offers, including 2x points on travel and 25% more value when points are redeemed for travel through Chase's Ultimate Reward. And this is important, all for the same annual fee. We love to see that. Now, those were all the new benefits that was announced. So next step I want to look at is through the perspective of someone who is doing some research on this card and trying to apply for the first time. Whenever they're applying for the first time, the first thing they should look at right here, big thing that jumps out immediately is that earn 100,000 bonus point. And that 100,000 bonus point is nothing to laugh at. If you simply redeem that points for just the cashback, you will have $1,000 free, just like that. And if you redeem through travel portal or use it for pay yourself back, you are guaranteed to earn $1,250. And if you decide to use it for transfer partners, you might get $2,000 or higher value if you just decide to use that 100,000 reward points to pay your annual fee and nothing else. That will cover you for 10 years. So moving on from the signup bonus, so this is what we already looked at before. This is the point earning potential plus that $50 in statement credit each account anniversary year for hotel stays purchased through the Ultimate Reward portal. Okay, so this one we already had, which is get 25% more value when redeemed through the travel portal. Yeah, we already know that, but the main thing I wanted to look at was this partner benefit. So all the Chase Sapphire Preferred card member will get complimentary Dash Pass. What that means is $0 delivery fee and reduced service fee on order over $12. And you have to activate it by December 31st, 2021. The Dash Pass costs $9.99 a month, which is easily $120 if you use Dash Pass. So next one we have is $60 Peloton credit. Now, just like the Dash Pass, if you use Peloton, that's great. You'll get a free $60 back. So other partner is Lyft. You can earn 5x points on Lyft ride through March 2022. Now, I also briefly want to touch on the travel and purchase protection. This card has some of the best one at this annual fee range. You can see them on the screen now. I have already done a full details video about the Chase Sapphire Preferred card. If you want to see full details about this, you can click right here to watch that video. But for now, let's do a quick recap. First, we have 100,000 UR points signup bonus. And even if you just calculate this as simple 1 cent per point for basic cashback, that's still $1,000. Next, we have the $50 anniversary hotel credit. Remember that this has to be redeemed through the Chase travel portal. Next, we have the complimentary Dash Pass. You can calculate this as either $120 or $0, but it's still offered to you in the first year. Lastly, we have the $60 Peloton credit. So as you can see, this card is well worth the $95 annual fee in the first year, but we all knew about that. Pretty much every card is worth it in the first year because of the signup bonuses. What we want to find out is that, is this card still worth it in the second year and years after that? So in the second year, you will not have the signup bonus. You will also not have the Dash Pass or the Peloton credits. So basically you'll have that $50 anniversary hotel credit and you will have that 10% anniversary bonus. So depending on how much you spent on this card, this could be a significant or negligible amount. For example, if you just decided to spend $4,000 on this card to complete that signup bonus, that's only 400 UR points. That's like $4. So on second years and onward, you really have to rely on the points multiplier, which have become little more competitive after the upgrades, but still not that much. Even Chase's own non-annual fee cards still compete with this card on the multipliers. But like I mentioned, this card has pretty good purchase and travel protection. So let me finally answer the question I asked in the beginning of the video. With all the new updates to the Chase Sapphire Preferred card, has this card finally become a long-term keeper card? So in my honest opinion, I would have to say no. Don't get me wrong, this card is fantastic value in the first year, as you saw before. But after that, I can't justify keeping it. Only possible reason I could think of keeping this card beyond the first year is for that travel and purchase protection. Just for $45, subtracting that $50 hotel credit, assuming that you can use that, you get some pretty good insurances. Plus, you get the primary collision damage waiver that itself could be very beneficial, and no other card in this annual fee range offers that. But for me, I would rather upgrade this card to Reserve and get better insurances and better perks and benefits. Even if I have to pay higher annual fee, that's okay if I can't justify the cost. Stay tuned for a video where I go deep dive on the Chase Sapphire Reserve card and determine whether it's worth the $550 annual fee. That being said, I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to like the video before you go. And if you have any question or disagree with my opinion about this card, please write them in the comments below. I would love to hear what you have to say. Other than that, I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.